Now, shopping for clothes really takes some time, but wouldn't it be great to bring all of our favourite designs together at our fingertips? Jess Wilson took that idea from dream to reality on your phone. Let's make a welcome to Studio 10. Hi. So you developed a phone app. It's called Stashed. I love the name. And it's popular right across the world. Mm-hmm. How exactly does it work?
So you present it with one item, and that item you can either swipe left to trash to never see again, or right to stash into a centralised virtual wardrobe. So instead of shopping for multiple different brands or retailers in all different locations, we've simplified it and centralised it and put it in the palm of your hand.
So it's like Tinder for fashion.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, wow.
I mean, this is like wonderful words for me. Easy shopping. I've actually installed it now on my phone. You showed me how to do this.
I did.
And so essentially, how does it work? This has popped up and I'm thinking... No, I don't,
like, don't like that one.
No,
don't
so
like that
I'll
one.
Bin it.
Yes.
Okay, don't like that.
Don't like that.
No. Yes,
she's
I like
ruthless,
that.
Ruthless, isn't she, J-Ro? Jeepers creepers.
You got to be quick, you know.
You do, yeah. It involves decision. So everything you like. So say if you like this one, it moves into your virtual wardrobe. Uh-huh. So this stores everything that you like from all of our different retailers and brands and everything. So say you want to go back and you want to purchase these Lee jeans, you can go back in there. You click on that, you can just go straight through and buy it.
Isn't that fab? Because at the moment, I go through every fashion website.
Exactly, it's frustrating.
You know, and then I take screenshots of what I like, and then my phone roll is absolutely chockers.
I did the exact same thing. Right. That's why I was like, let's simplify it and centralise it. And it's just so much fun as well. People get addicted to it.
I love that you had no IT training.
No.
You're a fashion girl.
How did you start off?
How did you get, you know... Into IT.
Yeah, so my background was I worked throughout Australia, New York and Paris Fashion Weeks, and I saw this certain demographic and I was like, nobody's speaking to these people in the right way. I had no tech training, so I booked a one-way ticket to Silicon Valley.
Did you?
I spent like my life savings, which was not much at the time, I was like 21, on booking out a hostel, ate noodles for 2 weeks and just learnt as much as I could.
And who did you meet there?
I met people from Google, Yahoo, Facebook and just went to different meetups and was like, tell me about this industry, I'm here to learn, and put myself through, I guess, my own tech internship.
So you came back then with this idea.
Yes.
How hard was it to set up? How did you manage to get
it? I mean, it was difficult. Definitely. I had to find a tech co-founder. I don't physically know how to code. I'm more so the business strategy, the fashion industry. That's my strength. Mm-hmm. So I found a tech co-founder who had those skills and we work super closely together and he does a lot of the coding and then I do a lot of the media and PR and business strategy. So we work really closely together.
So I'm addicted to it now.
I know.
Sorry, I'm just going.
We'll let you shop for a moment. How much money, I suppose, I mean, I love seeing young women heading into business and you know, becoming entrepreneurial. I think it's wonderful. Yep. Did you need a lot of money or did you just to start your business up or did you just have a real passion
not
and
at
a
all.
Drive?
No, not at all. It was very much bootstrapping, I guess they call it. Yep. So we had an idea, we had a passion. We're like, let's just try it out. Let's see how it goes. So we built it off not much at all. I think it was like even under $2,000. It was just like, let's see what we can do here. And then it scaled.
How though did you manage to do that? Because a lot of us have dreams and think,
definitely.
This is what I want to do.
Yeah.
You began to dream early, you wanted to get into fashion. Yeah. People said to you, you can't do it.
Yes.
But so how can someone at home who's thinking, I have a dream, I want to make this happen, what advice would you give them?
I think you just need to go out there and try it. Like, go to different meetups, go and try and meet new people, mentors. Just, if you can figure out what you want to do, it's just putting yourself in the right places and just not giving up. Just have persistence with what you want to do. If this is your dream, you owe it to yourself to do it.
I just came off 3 weeks of shooting Shark Tank and one of the entrepreneurs, one of the sharks, their motto was, you just got to get out there and break rocks.
Exactly.
And that means do the hard work.
Exactly. You and know, you'll fail really and you'll fail hard. A lot and you need to learn to fail fast. But it's just learning to not be discouraged by that as well. Like, we've failed so many times with new features and new everything that we do. But it's just looking at failure as not a horrible thing, but just a learning curve to get to where you need to go anyway.
Do you buy everything that's on your site?
I do. I'm bad. I'm horrible. Yes, I do. It's addictive.
Well, the Stash app can be found at the Apple iTunes store. Jess Wilson, kicking goals, breaking rocks. Thank you.
Thank you so much, guys.